Hey everybody, welcome to the channel. I'm going to be doing something today. Maybe some of you like, some of you don't. I had the vacuum leak problem on my car, and so I figured, because when I took the spark plugs out and I took the oxygen center out, everything was like covered in soot. So I figured things were running really rich. And so I can only imagine what the top of the pistons look like and in the intake runners and all that kind of stuff. So the car is warm. I was driving it just recently. And so what I'm gonna do is, see, I took that little nipple off. So hopefully, okay, so this nipple right here, I took that off. Now I'm gonna take my handy dandy rubber hose here. I'm gonna start the car up. It's gonna run like garbage. And then, once I get that, I gotta introduce some seafoam in there, and that should hopefully clean stuff up, because I can stick this in there and introduce a little bit and clean everything up. So that's my plan. Let's get to it. I'm just putting a little bit at a time in there. Not putting a lot in, just a little bit. Let it come back up. Show you, man. All right, so a lot of that condensation or whatever you see coming out is just, it's because it's cold out. It's like minus 10, minus 9 degrees Celsius right now. So that's why you're seeing steam. I'm not getting the big plumes of smoke and whatever that a lot of people get. So I'm not sure where that's coming from. I don't know. But I'm going to keep doing this. And then we'll go from there. Okay, now I'm starting to get the... This is the point where I got to open up the garage door some more. Okay, so I keep plugging it as I'm doing it, and then I don't get the big plumes of smoke until. And I just want to make sure you guys can see that I'm not just jabbing this in there. I'm just slowly tipping it, and you can feel it starting to suck through the hose. And then it sounds like it wants to die. And then I hold it, and then the revs come back up. Because I don't want to just send a whole bunch in there. Because that wouldn't be good. But, at the same time, I want to be able to do this. So, that's what I'm doing. right, so what did I learn? I learned that seafoam, it works good. Now, of course, how's it go? I should have put the GoPro on the back of the car, because when I started out and went down my neighborhood road, man, it smoked like a two-stroke, and a real bad running two-stroke, so almost like I was rolling coal. But once that got going, it blew out all that junk, and then took it out on the highway, revved it up to probably, I'm gonna say 110, maybe 120K for a few seconds, and then just kept the revs high as I went around some on-ramps and that kind of stuff, and then it turned out really, really nice. Now, one nice thing is the idle has come down a little bit. Since I did the intake gasket, my idle's been a little high. It definitely smoothed it out. I would say that just doing that, what I did with the thing and going through the whole bottle of the seafoam, it definitely has cleared out stuff. Now, maybe your car doesn't need it, but like I said, because it was running rich all the time with my vacuum leak, and it was just gross, when I took off those spark plugs, how coated they were and disgusting, and I knew that with my O2 sensor, if you look back at my other videos, you'd see that. It definitely was worth me doing this. Is it going to be amazing results for everybody? Probably not. There you go. What I was going to say, definitely, I was thinking about when I was driving it, definitely you need to have your car warm, like up to operating temperature, because otherwise you want the engine and the combustion chamber hot so that when this stuff vaporizes and it like almost like flash boils. Now, you're just introducing a small amount at a time. You're not like dumping water in there. So there is the risk of hydrolock, but there's not the huge risk that everybody thinks, because if you think about what your fuel injectors are doing, they're introducing a liquid into the combustion chamber. Now, I know it atomizes because it hits the airstream, but that's what this fluid is doing as well. It's sucking it in through the intake port. It's going down the intake runners at a high speed. It's vaporizing, and it's not just like as if I dumped a pail of water down a carburetor with the engine running, or sucked up copious amounts of water driving through a puddle with one of those low intakes, you know, those cold air intakes that suck the water in. It's not like that. So be careful if you're doing this. Now, again, I'm not an expert. So if you go and do this and you throw that tube in there and you blow up your engine, well, I'm sorry, I'm not buying you a new engine. However, if you do this process the way I was showing you, the way other YouTubers have shown you, I know Eric the car guy's got a good one. He even used straight water, and he just dumped little bits of water down his carburetor, and the car did not blow up, and the car did not die, and it just cleaned out his engine really, really well, because the water, it turns to steam. Steam has just hits it, and it breaks up all the carbon deposits. Now, obviously, I can't say for 100% certain what happened in my combustion chamber, on top of the cylinders, that kind of stuff, unless I tear everything apart. I can't. Now, real famous YouTuber Chris Fix, he did this, and he had a borescope, and he went down inside and took a look at everything before and after, and there was real results, and it really did clean. Now, he did a whole bunch of stuff, so you can choose which one you want to pick. I chose Seafoam. That's just the one I chose. Now, once again, it's up to you. So, thank you for watching. Thanks for hanging out with me this afternoon. Hope you guys have had a good day. And if you are interested, as I say in all my videos, I don't care if you subscribe or not, just click the ads, because I'm in it for the money.